The U.S. House of Representatives approved an $8.1 billion emergency aid package for key allies in the Indo-Pacific, including the Philippines. The bill allocates $4 billion in security assistance, nearly $2 billion in stock replenishment, and $3 billion in submarine infrastructure for America's allies. Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez says the measure will benefit Manila amid escalating tensions in the West Philippine Sea. Romualdez lobbied extensively for the bill during meetings with American legislators at Washington, D.C. earlier this month. The private firm operating the open parking space at Naiya's Terminal 3 will assume liability for the damage caused by a massive fire that destroyed 19 vehicles Monday. According to Manila International Airport Authority spokesperson Chris Bendijo, Philippine Skylanders International has committed to shoulder all damages incurred by the owners of the vehicles. He adds the owners of seven of the cars have already been identified and they're still trying to locate the other 12. The MIAA is still awaiting the results of the Fire Bureau's investigation into the incident. In the meantime, it has instructed the parking space operator to completely remove grass in the area and cover the parking lot with gravel.
Napansin po ng ating general manager na si Eric Ines, no? At talaga pong maraming tuyong-tuyong damo sa parking facility na ito. And when we inquired about this, nabanggit nga po ng operator na meron po dyan na portion sa property nga, no? Meron na po silang stockpile ng mga crushed rock at gravel. They were intending to, after cleaning the property from dry grass, they were intending to cover it, no? With itong crushed rock at gravel. Kaya nga lang po, nangyari na nga po itong unfortunate incident na ito.
President Marcos vows to alleviate the effects of the El Nino phenomenon on the agriculture sector. Marcos made that remark as he inspected the farmlands of Occidental Mindoro Province Tuesday. He told farmers there the government will set up irrigation systems to boost agricultural production in municipalities affected by El Nino. He also bared plans to build a dam for irrigation and to install solar-powered pumps.
Maglilimang buwan na nang walang ulan. Kaya at hindi lamang dito pero sa buong Pilipinas, yan talaga ang naging problema. Hindi lamang ang Pilipinas, kundi ang buong Asia. Ganyan din ang mga problema. Kaya sinama ko na lahat ng mga secretary, cabinet secretary ng iba't ibang departamento na makita nila kung ano talaga ang pangangailangan, kung ano ang kailangan gawin at para ma-implement kagad ang mga tulong na ibinibigay sa inyo.
Overseas now, extreme heat also scorches Bangladesh. A severe week-long heat wave has pushed temperatures there up to 43 degrees Celsius. Authorities have issued a nationwide heat wave alert Monday, which will last for 3 days. Schools have been shut for the whole week, and the public is urged to stay indoors. The government has also directed all hospitals to be prepared amid an expected increase in cases of heat strokes and dehydration. Asia was the most disaster-hit region from climate and weather hazards last year. That's according to the United Nations Weather and Climate Agency. The agency says Asia is facing more severe effects due to heat waves as the region warms faster than the global average. The annual mean near surface temperature over Asia last year was the second highest on record at 1.87 degrees Celsius above the average temperatures between 1961 to 2020. The WMO urged national weather services in Asia to improve tailored information to officials working on reducing disaster risks.